Hey guys, my name is Jessie Mew, and welcome back to the Hard Mode Challenge. In the last episode, our creatures began to explore some uncharted territory. And while they haven't found any barrieras to conquer yet, nothing new really off in this grass aside from more food to pick up, the barriera hybrids back home just keep getting stronger. We have Darkrai in the original hybrid nest, who has a 7 in attack strength, only to be rivaled by the sweet, unassuming Bambi with his 8 thanks to his double Barina claws. Now we just need a good female with the Barina snout in her genetics to potentially breed with one of our new males. Then we might get a full Barina hybrid, and then I think we can call ourselves ready for war. We can go out and try to actually hunt down the killer Barinas that were terrorizing us before. Let's just have Grindylo pick up his meat, though, because I am a little bit concerned that those pesky bluebirds are going to steal it on us. Zara learned that the hard way when she found that her food was stolen from right under her nose, but now she has a potential family to keep her busy instead. She's going to be breeding with our other friendly Barina, who is actually set up right on top of a permanent nest. Oh my gosh, that is adorable. He is definitely trying to catch her eye. So let's see what we can place into her mutation menu. Okay, we must have already placed the claw in here before. That's interesting. I was hoping to actually place the running leg in so we could hopefully breed out the deformed paw in a way that would keep her line quick for hunting. But I just noticed too that she has those web-tined legs, and since we have been seeing more and more of that pop up inside our tribe, maybe it would actually be a good idea to place the normal hind legs into her other mutation menu slot. Then she should be able to breed with the Barina. Oh no, that one actually didn't work. Okay, so she'll have to wait for the next turn. Unfortunately, Barina fertility is not really the best, so we're going to have to keep a close eye on that on their babies too. Webs, thankfully, has some pretty high fertility, but Bambi, on the other hand, has some of the lowest that he can possibly manage without being completely infertile. And it looks like you actually have some fish to scoop up here, Webs. Excellent. That's actually the perfect job for you. He can hop around in the water to keep his frog toes all nice and comfortable. And then he can scoop up some of our very first fish to feed to our families. It looks like Barker has another little bunny to hunt down. So let's scoot him over here to pick that off. Oh, it was stealing our berries. Good thing you found that for your babies. This little group is actually creating what will hopefully be our collecting line. They're going to stay in the mainland, of course, to keep a very close watch over all of these healing fruits and make sure that no wanderers are coming by to try to steal them on us. But we also have plenty of opportunities for them to gather up the berries, so these little babies are going to be very important to us. And even though they're weaker than many of our other tribe mates, they'll have lots and lots of guards to keep them safe. I would actually like to have our females move their nests maybe closer to the fruits. That way they can truly keep a good eye on them. So we'll have Liana set up on this side of the rock so she can wait for her mate to return. Grindylo, thankfully, is still hanging around, so he should be able to breed again with a little Biba. And then on her next turn, we'll move her nest as well. We'll just scoop this one up from right underneath her little baby's toes. Go ahead and collect your meat. And then we want to try to find our original friendly Barina. He seems to have wandered off again, probably looking for Athena. He's very, very attached to their first baby. But so far, I don't actually see him anywhere. Hopefully he's still around. Did he pass away by any chance? I suppose we would probably see his meat if he did. Oh my gosh. We couldn't see him in that sense because they were listening for him, trying to hear those familiar growls off in the distance. But instead, it seems as if they've stumbled upon the remains of Sagittaria's first mate. Oh, that is so sad. Well, I guess she's going to have to collect that on the next turn, too. I mean, it does mean more food for us, so we'll be able to support all of these new babies, but it is still super, super sad. Maybe it's a good thing that Athena is so far away, so she won't actually know what took place. But we'll leave her right there, very close by to all of our explorers, just in case anything goes wrong. We don't want them getting picked off by those Baryenas, because they're not quite strong enough to take care of the killer ones. Now, Pecan has one day left on his lifespan, so I was actually hoping that he might be able to start a little family with Comey. His high fertility would really help out where hers is not so great, and we can also pull those new immunity genes into our tribe, and the stripes too, we can't forget about those. So as we place something into Pecan's mutation menu, something to hopefully get rid of that deformed paw that he has, yeah, I guess the runner's leg would be the best one to choose. That way these creatures will be super, super speedy. They'll make very good scouts, in fact, as long as we can breed out those frog toes too. So we'll place the normal hind legs into his second slot, and then do the same for Comey, but she should be able to settle down right by the stream in this permanent nest, as long as the Totemingo doesn't steal it first. Then he can use his very final turn to just clear out some more of the grass, and now we should be ready to skip the turn. So since Comey is the only one giving birth on this turn, we'll zoom in right to her nest and see if maybe her baby will have the stripes. Oh, excellent. You can actually see them a little bit more easily on her baby than you can on her, but it's still going to help her camouflage into that tall grass. That's why we want these babies to be our future scouts. The creatures who maybe linger on the outskirts of the territory, making sure that the killer Baryenas are kept far, far away. Oh my gosh, Athena! You have actually attracted the attention of that exact creature. It's a brand new killer Baryena too. Not the old one that we were chasing before, because he's probably lost quite a bit more of his lifespan than that. So because he has a 3 in defense, that means that she's only going to be able to do 2 points of damage every hit. And that also means that her friends aren't going to be able to help her out very much. So we're going to have to be very, very careful as we take care of that guy. But first, let's go back and name our first little stripey baby, where things are much, much calmer over by the waterside. You must be very grateful for that, Comey. The next name on my list is Peppy. So welcome to the tribe, little one, and may you scout out many, many killer Baryenas in our future, so we're not left surprised by them like we are for this one. And before we attack them, I am also going to pick up the remains of our other friendly Baryena, just so the bluebirds don't get a nice big snack of that first. So hopefully your friends are going to be able to lead you safely away. We'll bring Piper down to the shore to swipe up that leech. We don't need you getting stuck by any leeches in the process. Then Athena can land a couple good blows on the Baryena. Oh, I don't think she's going to be able to run far enough away if she uses 2 of her turns. So just one, okay? Just one good hit to take down 2 days worth of his lifespan. Then it's going to be time to run. So because of her Baryena genetics, she's actually very, very slow. So that's going to be a part of the trouble as we try to keep them far away enough to survive. But as long as we don't stray too deep into that tall grass, I think we should be okay. He's far enough away now that we can't even hear him with our big ears. So hopefully that means he won't be able to take his first swipe. And that means it would be a good idea for our little healers to maybe consider enlisting the help of Darkrai. We need somebody to keep them safe too. And he is just about to grow his third gem. So while Sagittarius stays on the outskirts, mourning the loss of her Baryena mate, we'll have her son stand in as the first guard of the fruits. We'll have to shuffle around the babies a little bit just to make sure that they're safe too. Yeah, I definitely want them to stay a little bit closer to the fruits themselves. That's why we want to build our nursery over here. So we'll have Biba plop down her nest right between the fruit and the rock, and hopefully that'll keep her safe. Then Barker should be able to return to his mate's side as well, to hopefully breed with her again, so she can place down a nest right next to her sister. And we can have even more little collector babies if we're lucky. I guess that means, Grindylo, you are going to have to stay put, because those pesky bluebirds are always looking for trouble. Zara's going to have to track her potential mate down too. Oh my goodness, how on earth did you get all the way down to the ocean? We might actually have to have Sonya help you out of the grass, so you'll still be able to breed with the Baryena on this turn. Thankfully, Webb should be able to keep his little brother Bambi safe, as he continues to scoop up all of the lazy fish in the water. Then we'll see if Zara can slowly make her way out of that tall grass. Oh, please tell me this is going to work this time. No, the fertility got in the way again. Oh, that is so disappointing. Please don't run away on us at this time, okay, little guy? We want to have babies with you after all, before you end up passing away. He only has 6 days left on his lifespan. Now, the other thing I feel we need to get back to work on would be these poison berries. We have so many poison berry bushes and not a safe way to pick from them yet. So I think, Komi, you might be a good individual to help us out with that situation. If she can hopefully unlock the toxic body for us, then she should be able to have some more babies that can truly supply us with food. We're halfway there to unlocking this gene as well. So go ahead and use your other turns to pick the poison berries. And then once you need it, we'll have you take a trip over to the medicines to hopefully heal up. But that's all of our turns used for today. So let's go back to our very brave explorers and see if the killer Baryena is going to catch up to them. Oh, okay. It may have actually lost your trail. That is very interesting. It seems to be going into the ocean instead. I wonder if it's trying to escape us. Maybe it's trying to get to these killer ports and leave islands. Very mysterious. But unfortunately, Grindylo, it looks like a Baryena has caught your scent. And he only has 1 day remaining on his lifespan, so this is his last chance to keep his family safe. Naturally, I feel like he would sacrifice each and every last one of his turns to swipe away at the Baryena and take off as much damage as he can. He has so many little babies to protect, and unfortunately it looks like Darkrai is not going to be able to get there in time. He doesn't have his third and final gem yet, so he can't land the killing blow. That means we'll want to bring Kate down out of the way between all of these poison berry bushes. Okay, maybe you could help us out too then, just like Komi. We'll call your little sister Tumi down here too. That way she's very, very far away from the danger. Then we'll just have to set up some of our strongest creatures on the outskirts to protect our babies like a wall of claws. And now it should be safe enough for us to hopefully take a look at the little babies too. So it looks like one of them was actually born with the antlers. Oh, he's very pretty. He has the nimble fingers too. So yet another excellent collector who can help us scoop up all of our food. And his cousin is equally blessed with the nimble fingers, but it looks like he also has the Baryena claw. Oh my gosh, how fitting is that? With the Baryena looming behind him? That is a sign from our goddess of war if I ever saw one. So the next names on my list are Harry, and for his little antlered cousin, Jip. So welcome to the tribe, you two. Hopefully you will both live long enough to enjoy your youth. thanks to Grindylow's valiant sacrifice. I feel like this would be really hard for Barker to sit himself out of. He only has 4 days left on his lifespan, though. So if the Baragina turned around to attack him, if he set himself up right behind him, he would probably end up getting destroyed as well. So I think we're going to have to leave him right here. Maybe we could move him to the side just to pick up a little bit more of the grass. That way, nothing else can spawn in the meantime. But these warriors are going to be watching very closely as Grindylow's life comes to an end, learning from the best how to protect their tribe. I hope Sagittaria is doing okay too. It looks like she doesn't have any dangers way out here. She doesn't even have any little pesky bunnies trying to steal her berries. So for the most part, the beaches are quite calm, except for this one, where Zara is going to try, yet again, to breed with the Baragina, and this time it actually worked. So you know, Zara, just set up your nest right here. I know we wanted to use the nursery off in the grass, but I think it's a little bit more important that you have your baby now. Bambi, at least, now that he has his second gem, should be able to scoot off this way to try to clear out that area for you later. Oh, and don't tell me that leech is going to attach to our mother. Hopefully it hasn't noticed her yet. Maybe it's a little bit too intimidated by that giant Baragina. Or maybe not. Unfortunately, Zara, somebody is going to have to pick that off of you on the next turn. Komi can go ahead and keep gathering up her berries as little Peppy takes her first steps out of the nest. Watching that bunny very closely, I'm sure. It's scooting all around the grass, trying to find some food to eat. Oh, Webs, you better keep that guy pinned down for us. We do still have a little bit of work to do here, after all, just to make sure that our explorers are going to be safe, because I think they do need to hightail it a little bit further away from the killer Baragina. I mean, not too far away, because we don't really want it to lose our scent entirely, but we also don't want our creatures taking tons and tons of damage. I think Piper should be safe right on this bunny burrow, so let's just clear out the grass for us. Not for the Baragina, we don't want him using our pathways, but if we can make sure that we still have a way to escape, then I think we'll be able to survive this one. But let's go back to Grindylow tonight. We'll watch as he makes his final sacrifice just to protect his babies. Oh my goodness, and just in time too. Oh, poor little Biba. It looks like the Baragina has found one of our weakest tribe mates, but he's also set up right next to Darkrai, and he is not going to let this stand. So with one swipe from his mighty claw, the Baragina is already taken care of, and now we can pick up all of that delicious meat to feed to your babies. And Webs, you better take care of this bunny too before one of those bluebirds does instead. Before we take a look at the Baragina's baby, though, I just want to make sure, oh my goodness, that everyone's doing okay out here. I didn't notice that before. Oh my gosh, we actually have another healing fruit by this tree? That is actually perfect. So even if you guys do end up taking a little bit of damage, you should be fine because we have a lovely healing fruit to keep you alive. Alright, so Athena, I guess that means you can play this with a little bit more risk involved. We'll scoot her closer, so hopefully the Baragina will take chase again. And then we should be able to land some nice, good, solid hits to whittle away at his lifespan. I'm pretty sure the baby in the Baragina's nest was a female, though. Excellent, so let's take a look at her immunity genes. And hopefully they're going to line up perfectly with our males. Oh, yes. So that means that we should actually be able to pull that Baragina snout in our next generation. If we're lucky. She even has some pretty decent fertility too. So that bodes very well for us. Now the next name on my list is Amelia. So welcome to the tribe, little one, and hopefully you will become the mother to our first true hybrid line. Let's actually have little Bambi come over here and pick that leech off of Zara. off of his future mother-in-law if all goes well. Then Sonia, since you're part of the family too, let's bring you over here to lick her wounds. And then hopefully she'll be able to breed again with the friendly Baragina. There we go, now we're at least having a little bit more luck. So Webs, if you don't have any more fish to find, nope, it looks like those lazy fish are still swimming right inside that waterfall. So we might as well bring Sonia into the grass instead to finally clear out that nursery. Maybe if we're lucky, we'll even find more healing fruits out this way. There's still a lot of tall grass that we have yet to explore. So I think it's time to take some of our creatures out into the wilderness. And Peppy, that sounds like the perfect job for you. With your nice big nose, you should be able to sniff pretty far. Yeah, she can already smell some delicious berry bushes to pick from. Or maybe for her mother to pick from instead, since they're probably just the toxic berry bushes that she knows so well. It's probably about time that she starts hopping her way over to those medicines too. So we'll let her use one of the healing fruits on the next turn. And we'll just keep a very close eye on the babies to make sure that nothing comes out to snag them up. Looks like we spoke too soon, Sagittaria. This little bunny has made a feast of your berry bush. It's kind of leading her back up to the main tribe, though. So maybe it was kind of a blessing in disguise, giving her a reason to come back to her baby and hopefully heal in the presence of her tribe mates once more. Now I think, Kate, with your nimble fingers, you would be a very, very good candidate for picking those poison berries too. So we'll have her help us out with our toxic berry line as well. Actually, if we could get the nimble fingers on the creatures with the toxic body, I think that would probably be our best combination for food collecting in this land. Now as we spread out the creatures right around our nursery, make sure that all of our babies are kept safe. We could actually have them toddle their way out of the nests for the very first time, next to their mothers, so they can have a little bit more room to run around. I think Biba is the only one who's a little bit too timid to go exploring. Without the claw to keep her protected, and without the ram horns on top of her head, she would much rather try to paw at the ground, maybe dig up some little roots for her babies, as the bunnies hop around behind her. I think she would even be too weak to take those down in one swipe. So let's go back to our explorers again, and just see if maybe Athena has succeeded in catching the eye of our killer Baragina. Okay, she definitely has, but this is what we needed to see. So let's check how much she has on his lifespan still. 20 more days. Okay, you really have your work cut out for you, little one. Let's have you land that extra swipe in again, and then slowly start leading him in the direction of the healing fruit. We'll bring Piper down here to lick your wounds. Oh, she's actually not bleeding. Okay. Excellent. It must be because she has normal blood clotting. Very, very good. So you are truly the warrior of our tribe. Hello, little Dodomingo. Just enjoying the show? Well, you might want to scoot a little bit further into that grass, because you are going to end up in the Baragina's crosshairs if you're not careful. We did also unlock one of our genes, so I'm just curious to see what that might have been. Oh, I think it was actually higher fertility. We must have survived here for 50 days. Oh my gosh, 50 days in the Deadly Hills, can you guys believe it? And honestly, we haven't had too many major tragedies. So far, our tribe has been very, very lucky. If you don't count the leeches anyway. So Bambi, if you wouldn't mind again, maybe you could scoot on down here to help out your future mother-in-law as she makes her way up toward the nursery. I think she should be able to scoot her way around Sonia. There we go, and then you guys just need to slowly clear out this land. That way, nothing is going to be able to spawn and surprise you. Though I'm sure your friendly Baragina would swoop in and save the day. That gives Peppy a good opportunity to maybe meet these creatures as well. Show off her wonderful sniffing abilities. Let's see if she can smell anything else in the tall grass. Unfortunately, none of those healing fruits that we're looking for. But she's going to keep searching. I bet that's going to be her life's mission. She's probably looking for the healing fruits just to help her mother with her job, because she knows it takes such a heavy toll on her body. But it's all for a good cause, because pretty soon, we should be able to start our little toxic body line. Let's see, we're at 34 out of 50 actions so far. We might want to bring Barker back to the nursery as well, so he should be able to have another baby with Liana before he passes away. Another strong warrior. A warrior slash collector anyway, just like Harry. So he knows that his whole family will be safe even after he's gone. And you have just summoned the bunnies, Sagittaria. Let's have you jump on this one too and gather up that meat. As maybe Tomi can follow in your lead. Unfortunately, she's another creature who is not quite strong enough to take down the bunnies in one hit. But that doesn't mean that she wouldn't go chasing after them. I bet she's quite inspired by your hunting abilities. Jip might even be able to help you. He can jump all the way down here and pick off the bunny once and for all. There we go, so no more bunnies terrorizing our tribe mates. Beepa, I think you're going to have to stray a little bit farther away from the safety of your nurseries, because we do have that lovely berry bush for you to potentially pick from. So we'll clear this out so we can at least see it in the future. And then I suppose we could bring Harry down to the water side. That way, if there's any more fish swimming around, you can scoop them up for your newest sibling. And oh my goodness! We have a literal family of bluebirds just circling above the stump. Maybe we should have our explorers make their way back, and a fourth one over here too? Whoa! That is a lot of bluebirds for one island. Okay, well let's zoom in on you guys as we skip the turn one last time. Bring the rain with us too. Oh, excellent. That means that we should be able to pick up tons and tons of food. But first, oh no, little Chip, I think the Barryina is coming after you. Oh, you poor thing, you must have attracted it over here with the smell of that meat, of course. So your family's going to have to rush to protect you. But with two more babies to meet, let's see what our next little collector looks like first. Oh, wait a second. Not a collector at all. Oh, she is like a true warrior. Would she be able to breed with Darkrai by any chance? I think she actually can. Their immunity genes do line up. That's a good sign. Of course, she doesn't have the Barryina snout in her traits, because she doesn't have any Barryina genetics in her line. But they would still make an excellent group of guards for our little collectors. So we'll have to keep that in mind. The next name on my list is Green Glacier, but we'll call her Glacier for short. So welcome to the tribe, little one, and I'm sure you're going to do an excellent job keeping everybody safe. Your father has nothing to worry about. Even though this might be his last day, even though there are Barryinas looming down in his family, he knows that everyone's going to be all right. And then last but not least, we have one more little Barryina baby to take a look at over here. Takir with a very interesting mane. Little Barryina fur right between his two ears. And his name will be Rocket. So welcome once again to our tribe. And in the next episode, we're going to have to set our warriors out to defend our babies. Jip, I suppose, could probably land a couple of good swipes himself, but he's still not suited to taking down any Barryinas anytime soon. So he's going to have to swallow his pride and run for the hills so he can live to see another day. But for now, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye, guys!